It's been going on, as far as I can tell now, it's been going on ever since humanity has been here. It didn't just start in 1949.
Lieutenant Colonel Wendelle C. Stevens was one of the world's most renowned UFO researchers.
Over 60 years of research, it's completely reversed. I think that the incidence of faking or hoaxing is very, very small, less than 2 or 3%, because it's so hard to do and so hard to carry out.
Born in 1923 in Round Prairie, Minnesota, Wendelle enlisted in the U.S. Army in 1941, and in 1942 was then transferred to the Air Corps. He served in the Pacific Theater during World War II. When he returned from the war in 1945, he was reassigned to the Flight Test Division of the Air Technical Service Command at Wright Field, Dayton, Ohio, as a flight test pilot. He also performed desk duties at the Air Technical Intelligence Center, where his job was to supervise a team of language translators reading and classifying the mountains of captured former enemy documents.
I was in Wright Field at the Air Technical Intelligence Center when the Roswell crash supposedly occurred. I was not in the need-to-know loop then. I was doing something else. I was screening classified documents from Europe, former enemy documents captured. I had teams of translators doing this. And I was not in the need-to-know loop on the UFO phenomena, although I now know that we had 4 crash recoveries even before Roswell.
About July 1947, Wendelle was reassigned to the frontier in Alaska to photograph and map the Arctic land and sea area where the data collecting equipment on board B-29s detected UFOs. It was here that his passion for ufology would truly be ignited.
I wish they would do a true movie one time, just one time, of all the facts as they really are. They're more exciting than all the entertainment they can create to make it exciting. They don't need romance, they don't need chases, they don't need explosions. The fact that extraterrestrials from another planet are here visiting us and interacting with us regularly and have been doing so ever since humanity has been here, that is the most exciting thing to me in the world.
Stevens also served as U.S. Air Attaché in South America. He retired from the United States Air Force in 1963 and worked for Hamilton Aircraft until 1972. Wendelle Stevens was actively involved in ufology for over 50 years and at one time was the Director of Investigations for the Aerial Phenomena Research Organization in Tucson, Arizona.
It still is probably the biggest and best collection of UFO material in private hands in the world. This is my library, my personal collection, thousands of books from all over the world.
He accumulated one of the largest collections of UFO photos and investigated a number of contact cases. He also published more than 22 books. In 2009, Wendelle wanted to find a decent home for his library and transferred ownership to Open Minds Production.
So a time came when I thought I should start downsizing. I had the largest collection of UFO books in private hands in the world, the largest collection of periodicals in private hands in the world, a big collection of video documentaries, and at 86 years of age, I thought, this is too much for my young wife. She'll never know what to do with it. I should downsize somehow.
Wendelle has amassed a library on ufology that contains over 3,000 books, videos, periodicals, and numerous other items from around the globe.
Now, if I can call your attention to something interesting here. This is the only true image of an alien head. This came from the case in Charleston, South Carolina, involving Bill Herman. In the evening, I'd go to the used bookstores in whatever country I was in and buy all the UFO books they had on the shelf. And here are the photographs, actual photographs. These are taken with a dollar camera, a pinhole camera, in Hallam, Australia. Open Minds now has all of my files, all of my books, all of my periodicals, all of my photographs, and all of my video collections.
Wendelle's purpose and passion to bring the truth of ufology to the forefront of human consciousness has had an impact that has reached globally.
Now, I work alone as one man. I've never been a member of a club or anything else. And if I can collect all this material alone as one man, what can a government have in its hands that has every agency of the government, every employee is a potential collector for the government? They must have hangers full of stuff that we have never seen and may never, ever see or hear about.
In this last interview with Wendelle, taped July 23rd, 2010, Wendell expressed his view on the condition of the planet.
I think we are blindly looking at what's going on, and we're not analyzing the situation sanely enough. If we were sane, we wouldn't be building and destroying. We would get out of our belligerence and manage to build our technology and the technologies that are needed to escape the planet before it's too late and survive like others. But a remnant will do it anyway, or they'll be carried away by somebody else, because in the infinite vastness of creation, there is no other duplicate. If a remnant is lost, it's gone forever, and it's a part of the creation itself that is now missing. And I don't think that's going to be allowed to happen.
Wendell will truly be missed.